Hello guys, and this is Chirudeep once again, and you're watching Coach Hour tutorial series. In this tutorial, I'm gonna tell you how you can adopt this tiger in your house. No, no, don't worry. I'm just kidding. In this tutorial, I'm gonna tell you a little bit of introduction of interface, and we will be using interface in Java. So before start coding, I'm going to tell you a little bit of introductory theoretical concept about interface in Java. Now, what is interface? Interface is basically a 100% abstract class. You know, we have implemented abstract class in my previous tutorial. So, interface are 100% abstract class, and it will actually not have even a single implementation. But we can't create an object also. Like abstract class, there are very similarities between interface and abstract class. You will get to know more about this while we are coding. Now, for till now, you understand that interface are 100% abstract class, and that is an interface will not have a single implementation. Okay, we can't create an object of an interface. Now, by default, every method inside an interface is public and abstract. So this is a very crucial point. By default, every method, okay, whenever you are declaring any method in your interface, those method will be by default, according to Java compiler, will be public and abstract, and every attribute is static and final. For method, every method will be public and abstract, and for any attribute, whichever you are declaring, will be static and final automatically. Now, inside interface, we can declare methods and attributes. We can't define methods which can't keep constructor, IIB, SIB like that. So we can't keep constructor, IIB and SIB in your interface. And also we can't have non-static attribute inside interface, and also we can't have static methods inside interface. Now, one interface can extend more than one interface. Now, this is a pretty cool concept. Actually, we will be just having multiple inheritance sort of things by implementing interfaces. Okay, so interface can be used as multiple inheritance, like C++, where you are using multiple inheritance in C++, but Java doesn't support multiple inheritance. But through interface, you can have the multiple inheritance sort of things in your program. And compiler generate dot class file for interface. Okay, if you are declaring one interface, then if you run this program or compile the program, then compiler will have dot class file for your interface, and through interface we can achieve 100% abstraction. Remember, I have told you in my previous tutorial that abstract class are not 100% abstract, and I have given you one example for that also. But in interface we can achieve that 100% abstraction, and if you are trying to keep any definition block, then you are violating interface meaning. Okay, you can't create any definition block. So let's move to our program to get to know more about this interface. Okay, now here I have defined one interface. You can see that iface01, it is an interface, and it's automatically public. Okay, so I have defined one public interface, iface01, and I have defined one static void method. Now, as I have told you that all the methods will be public and abstract. Okay, so you can't just give static method inside an interface. So that's why it's showing error. And if you go through this, you will get to know why it is coming error. You can see that only public and abstract are permitted inside the interface. So it will not compile and it will show you error. Now, moving to the next program, I have given one static final integer, and here also we are getting one error. And what the error is? You have defined that the blank final field I may not have been initialized, okay? So you can't give static final attribute, okay? Automatically it's all a static and final, so I cannot be initialized for that, and you will be getting error. By default, attributes are static final inside an interface. You don't have to explicitly just define that I'm trying to define my variable as static final. So it's by default already static and final. Now moving to the next next program. Here I have not defined any public static something like that, static and final, but also it's showing error. Why? Because you can't create or can't keep non-static attribute inside an interface also. This is pretty cool stuff. You can't just non-static attributes, you can't declare non-static attributes inside an interface, so that's why it's showing error. Now moving to the next program, you will get an error because you can't create constructors or IAB or SIB for your interface. Although your compiler will be generating dot class file similar to your previous concrete class files, but in interface we can't create a constructor or IAB or SIB. Okay, so it will show you error. Now moving to the last segment of this, you can't give or define methods also. Okay, so no definition block will be provided, only you can just declare the method, but no definition block is allowed inside your interface. Now all these things are pretty much introductory statements or introductory things so that we can be able to use interface in Java. Now I am creating one program over here. Let's have a look. I am creating one interface over here, interface A, okay, and I am defining one test one method over here and one abstract method over here. That is, your test one method is a concrete method and your abstract method is also a method which is abstract. So I'm not defining any definition block over here. I'm just declaring the method, okay, method name and type. Okay. Now again, I'm defining one interface B, and keeping abstract is optional. Okay, you can just have this keyword abstract is optional. You can have this keyword, or you may not declare this keyword. That is according to you. Okay, so keeping abstract is optional. Now what's happened over here? Class C implements A. Okay, you can implement interface A by writing the keyword implements. Okay, so in our classes we have seen that we have just written extends keyword. Okay, now for implementing interface or using interface in your class, you have to write implements. This is also a pretty crucial thing. Now what I'm doing in my class C is that I'm defining my test one method and test two method, which I have written or which I have declared in my interface A. And from my manager class, in main method, I am creating an object of class C, which is pretty much possible because class C is a concrete class. So I am creating one object and I am calling those methods test1 and test2 via this C1 object. And if you run this program, you will get output as test1 and test2. Yeah, you can see the output is test1 and test2. Now moving to the next program. Here also I have given one example that you can't create object of your interface. Okay, I'm not extending my class interface, I'm not extending the interface D in my class manager 2. So and also you can't create object of your interface if you are declaring any class which is extending or sorry which is implementing your interface. And you can then create object of that class, and through that you can access the methods or attributes from that. But you can't directly just define any object of your interface. So this is also a pretty important thing. And now moving back to the next program, here I have given one interface E, and I have declared one test one method and test two method. That is a concrete method, no abstract method. So you can create abstract method in your interface also. You will know how you can be able to create those type of methods later. So in this particular program, what we have done is we have created one interface E, and we have declared test1 and test2 method. And now I am creating one class H, which is implementing interface E. Now I am just overriding the test1 method and in my class H only, okay. And class I have also declared, which is extending class H, as because class abstract class H is the abstract class and it is a general type of class, so you can extend, but in case of interface you have to implement, okay. So in my case, in class I am extending class H, so test1 will be there in my class I, and I am overriding test2 method in my class I. Now coming back to the manager class, what I have done is I have created one object of class I, which is a concrete class, so I can create object, and from that I am accessing test1 method and test2 method. So if you run this program, you will get output of test1 and test2 like this. Now before wrapping up this tutorial, let's have a look in the last program. Here I have defined one interface ITest, and I have declared one test1 method and another class, that is abstract class G, which is implementing this ITest interface, and I have defined another test2 method in my abstract class, and which is an abstract method. Now again I have created another class K, which is abstract and which is extending the class J. So abstract class is a class type, and is a, you can consider it as a class, so we can extend another class, okay. So I am extending abstract class, I am extending the abstract class J in my abstract class K, and also I am overriding the test1 method. So remember one thing, friend, that if you are overriding your method which is declared in your interface, so that method should be termed as public, okay. This is a very vital point. You have to give the name as public, okay. So public void test1 I am giving, and again I am writing void test2 for the abstract void test2 method in my class J. So again I am creating another class, class L, which is extending class K, that is this upper method, upper class. And in my manager class I am just creating object of L. So in my L class I have not defined anything, just I have defined the opening parenthesis and closing parenthesis, but all the things of the K class will be available in my L class because we are extending class K. Now I am creating one object of L class, and I am just accessing obj.test1 and obj.test2. So if you run this program, you will get an output of test1 and test2. So this is the introductory part of interface, and in my next tutorial I am going to show you how we can achieve multiple inheritance through interface, and that will be also very good fun. So I hope you have liked it, and thanks for watching.